के साथ घर था मेरा। घर पे आके रात में हम सबको जान के लिए भागने में मजबूर कर दिया।
पुलिस वालों ने लाइब्रेरी को बुरी तरीके से तोड़ के उसमें अंदर घुसे हैं, उसमें लोगों को, बच्चों को मारा है, लड़कियों को मारा है, मारते मारते वॉशरूम तक ले गए हैं, वहाँ मार मार के उसको बेहोश कर दिया गया। वहाँ पे कौन सा प्रोटेस्ट चल रहा था? ये दिल्ली पुलिस कायरता वाला काम कर
रही है। was in charge of leading this attack is has to be held to standards.
ये movement जामिया का नहीं था, ये movement हर एक हिंदुस्तानी का है। यहाँ पे सिर्फ जामिया इन्वॉल्व नहीं है, यहाँ JNU इन्वॉल्व है, AMU इन्वॉल्व है और यहाँ के सारे जितने भी हिंदुस्तान के लोग हैं वो सारे इन्वॉल्व हैं।
A day after violent protests at Jamia University near the Jamia Millia University, today we saw thousands get out on the streets, not just in Jamia, not just in Delhi University, but across the cities of our country. Students, viewers, are now leading these protests from the front. Students from nearly 15 cities took to the streets, and we counted at least 16 colleges and universities, from IITs in Mumbai, Chennai and Kanpur, to protests being seen in Aligarh, Guwahati, Hyderabad, Bengaluru and so many more cities. Just 24 hours earlier, Delhi's Jamia Nagar, near the Jamia Millia Islamia University, saw massive violence. The university has alleged that police used excessive force against the students of the university who had nothing to do with the violence, who were peacefully going about their own lives or peacefully protesting. Take a look.
और हम लोग ये रिक्वेस्ट अपने मंत्री जी से करेंगे और वो किस लेवल से कर सकते हैं वो कराएं, क्योंकि ये देखने के लिए कि अंदर आके उनकी यूनिवर्सिटी के अंदर बिना इजाजत की पुलिस का आना और उसके बाद इतने प्रॉपर्टी का और हमारे मेंटल बच्चों के जो मेंटल स्टेटस है उसका इतना डैमेज करना, ये जो है क्या ऐसा अलाउड है किसी भी यूनिवर्सिटी के अंदर? इसलिए उसके ऊपर एक रिक्वेस्ट करेंगे और बहुत स्ट्रॉन्ग रिक्वेस्ट करेंगे कि प्लीज इसके ऊपर एक हाई लेवल इंक्वायरी हो जाए और देखें कि क्या गलती थी, किसकी गलती थी और क्या ऐसा यूनिवर्सिटी, सब यूनिवर्सिटीज के लिए रूल बन रहा है कि आपके यहाँ पुलिस घुस जाएगी ऐसी?
एक जो वही आपको मैं बता रहा हूँ कि जैसे हमने इनको पीछे पुश करना शुरू किया, कि वो रोड से पुश करना शुरू किया, दोनों साइड से जब पथराव हुआ हो रहा था तो उस समय जो टीयर गैस वगैरह यूज हुई है उसमें जैसे भी रॉडीज जो भी एलिमेंट्स हैं, मिसक्रिएंट्स हैं, वो जैसे अंदर गए हैं कुछ चेज करते हुए पीछे पुलिस वाले गए हैं उनको चेज करने निकालने के लिए, क्योंकि पथराव वगैरह बहुत हो रहा था। उसकी वही है कि एक डिटेल इन्वेस्टिगेशन हम भी कर रहे हैं। और सेकंड जो आपने बताया कि रेजिडेंट्स, उसमें कुछ रेजिडेंट्स भी थे, उनका भी हम आइडेंटिफाई भी कर रहे हैं और उनके खिलाफ एक्शन भी लेंगे।
The police have stood their ground. They say that they had to take retaliatory action to neutralize the situation. They say protesters had entered the university and they attacked the policemen as well. In fact, police has also blamed fake news and rumor mongering for the violence. Tonight on the urban debate, I asked this question. Is this organic? Why is young India feeling angry, and so angry, not just in Jamia Millia but across the country? And more importantly, are politicians fueling the unrest in campuses, hijacking the campuses for their own political motives? If there were outsiders who entered this protest, who made it go violent, who entered the university, who are these outsiders? Who is spreading fake news? Who is spreading fake news via social media and WhatsApp accounts and putting up these fake posts to incite people? What's going on? Let's say good evening to T.R. Kakkar, former commissioner of police in Delhi, Mr. A.L. Banerjee, former DGP from Uttar Pradesh, Umar Khalid, alumni of JNU, currently associated with civil rights group United Against Hate. I've also got Safiyat Naseem, a fourth-year law student with the Jamia University. And Safiyat, I want to come to you first and understand from you what went wrong. You know, how many of your colleagues have now simply packed their bags and gone home?
The protest from our side was fully and in an organized manner. We were not violent at all. ये जो कुछ भी शुरू हुआ था ये सब पुलिस ने शुरू किया था. We were on our way, was organized. And जो कुछ भी हुआ ये इसमें मेरे फ्रेंड्स, मेरे कलीग्स बहुत सारे, हम लोगों ने मार्च निकाला at 12:30. हम लोगों ने बटला हाउस की साइड से मार्च निकाला एंड इट वॉज ऑल फाइन टिल देन. जब हम लोग दूसरी वाली साइड में जाने लगे, हम कुछ बच्चे यूनिवर्सिटी के अंदर आ गए, सम वेंट आउटसाइड, उसमें कुछ लोकल्स भी होंगे, आई डोंट नो, दे वर बैरिकेटर्स, वी वर नॉट अलाउड टू पास दैट बैरिकेटर्स, हम लोगों को पीछे रोक लिया गया. आई डोंट नो व्हाट वाज द रीजन टू पुट अस बिहाइंड दोस बैरिकेटर्स, हमको आगे क्यों नहीं जाने दिया उस चीज के. अगर हम लोग किसी चीज के लिए प्रोटेस्ट कर रहे हैं, वी आर द यूथ्स ऑफ दिस कंट्री, इट्स आवर राइट टू प्रोटेस्ट. अगर हमें कोई चीज गलत लग रही है, व्हाई आर दे स्टॉपिंग अस फ्रॉम दिस. हमें स्टॉप करके पीछे कर दिया गया, वहां पे मारपीट शुरू करी गई एंड द फेक न्यूज स्प्रेड की हम लोगों ने बसेस जलाई हैं, जबकि हमारे पास फुल्ली वीडियो है कि वो बसेस पुलिस ने खुद जलाई थी एंड दे जस्ट नीडेड अ रीजन कि उन्होंने हमारे पर वायलेंस क्यों किया. इस बात का रीजन भी उन्होंने खुद ही क्रिएट किया और फिर हमारे पर वायलेंस भी उन्होंने खुद ही क्रिएट किया.
पर जो पत्थर फेंक रहे हैं, जो पुलिस के साथ क्लैश कर रहे हैं, वो कौन है फिर सफेद? वो भी तो स्टूडेंट्स, वो भी तो इस प्रोटेस्ट का पार्ट थे. हर बार ये
मे बी
कैसे होता है कि बाहर से कोई आ जाता है, JNU, जादवपुर, you know, do you think there is
because locals, something locals is going wrong? Joined us, बटला हाउस से हम लोगों का बटला उससे मार्च निकला था. मे बी locals joined us and also it was the police who started first. तो अगर हमारी तरफ से भी था तो वो बाद में था. वी हैव टू टेक प्रिकॉशंस. द मॉब वेंट एंग्री. प्रोटेस्ट में होता है ऐसा, जब आप हमें आगे जाने से रोक रहे हैं, हमारी आवाज सप्रेस कर रहे हैं, हमारे पास फायरिंग कर रहे हैं, तो ऑब्वियसली, और वी आर स्टूडेंट्स, हमारे पास कोई वेपन्स नहीं है, तो हमें जो मिलेगा हम फिर करेंगे टू सेव आवर सेल्फ, टू प्रोटेक्ट आवर सेल्फ.
Okay, let me actually get in Mr. Kakkar, who's former commissioner of police of Delhi. Mr. Kakkar, time and again, and I counted at least 6 times this year itself, the Delhi police has been accused of using excessive force when it comes against protesters. What's your own view, sir? How was the situation handled?
First of all, I would like to know from this young student, young lady, as to what were they protesting for? Have they really gone through the cap? Have they gone through the provisions of the cap?
Yes, sir, we have gone. We are
it
against
does not,
cap.
It does not affect. It does not touch. It just listen to me. Have patience. This cap is not against Indians. I have used the word Indians. It is only to give citizenship to the persecuted minorities from 3 countries. And Muslim word is not there because these 3 countries are Islamic countries and it is expected that the Muslims cannot be persecuted.
Mr. Kakkar, with all due respect,
that is all that it says.
Mr. Kakkar, with all due respect, tonight the debate is not about the merits of Citizenship Amendment Act, sir. Tonight the debate is about why there are unrest and protests across campuses. And if what Delhi police did was excessive, who are these outsiders who are fueling this violence, among student protests? So I don't want to go that road. I don't think it's the job even of the Delhi police to go into the merits of the protest. If the students wanted to protest, they wanted to protest. That's fine in our country.
And if such a large amount of protest is going on in each and every country, there has to be something wrong, right? We are students. We are studying.
Law.
We know.
Safiyat, let's just listen. Let's just listen to Mr. Kakkar. I'll come back to you, Safiyat.
You are not the law.
T.R. Kakkar, go ahead, please.
Have patience. Now, any law that is passed will have a few people or a number of people who will not see eye to eye with that particular law. So is this cap. Now, students perhaps of some color felt that this is the time now to give vent to our feeling, and they did not have the intention of indulging in violence. But the people who really were interested of setting fire to the country or to the city got involved in it, and then they started what they normally do is make use of. These were used. I am not saying that they were used as pawns. Anybody who organizes a protest is responsible for the conduct of that assembly. We take it like that. Now this young student was telling us, why were they stopped? All processions and demonstrations are stopped at a certain point. And then they are told that you cannot go beyond this particular. So the stopping is not unjust, it is not illegal, it is done for a reason.
But is
and
is,
it is there that the violence erupted.
Is forcefully pulling out people
erupted,
from there.
You can see,
forcefully pulling out people, dragging people out of their hostels and libraries and washrooms, Mr. Kakkar. Is that part of the Delhi police protocol?
No. Listen,
the same Delhi police doesn't show so much of vigor when it comes to fighting the lawyers.
It is not that. I think the media and other people, it is so easy to blame the police. You tell me under these circumstances, when there's heavy stone pelting going on, vehicles are being set on fire, what is the police required to do? If some of you can explain to me, that this is what exactly police should have done.
Let me ask Umar Khalid that question.
I would like to be, the question is, when the students are at creating rampage, when students are not agreeing to the directions of the police.
We don't know if they were all students, Mr. Kakkar. That's the whole point. We don't know if they were all students. The Delhi police, to begin with, failed with their own intelligence to find out.
We even have the proof that police did this. What is the proof that students were involved in this? You don't have any proof. Okay, even we have photos of police putting up the fire.
I've told you, anybody who organizes the protest is responsible
people
for the
people wearing camouflage jackets may not necessarily be police. One minute, Mr. Kakkar. One minute, Mr. Kakkar. I disagree with you. It is the job of the police to know what's going on. It is the job of the police to know if hundreds or thousands have gathered and who are these people and if they're actually dangerous elements to the society or peaceful students who are protesting there. Police cannot later on go looking inside hostels and girls' hostels and libraries and dragging people and beating people out of those libraries.
You organize something, make sure that people who are participating in that they have the same view that you have of peacefulness. But if there are others who have taken advantage of the political leaders have taken advantage of you, the ruffians have taken advantage of you, so the police has to move. Police cannot be a witness to the destruction there.
Look at this visual that's actually going on. Look at what went on inside the college. There are no protesters inside this college. There are people there. Tear gas shells are being lobbed. They're in this one classroom. They're trapped in libraries. They were trapped in their own hostels. Look at the state of the premises. How did things come to this? Umar Khalid, every single time, how are we told that outsiders are responsible for what really happened here? One minute, Mr. Kakkar, if I can just...
pelting stones from inside the campus.
Umar Khalid, if stones are pelted and petrol bombs are thrown, then why blame the police for the retaliatory action that's taken? Umar, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Just give me a second.
Yeah. Now, we can hear you. The question to you is, if stones are pelted and public property is destroyed and petrol bombs are thrown, then why complain about retaliatory action from the police?
See, one thing I would like to make it very clear. I was at the police and I was...
last night. I spoke to different students who were arrested inside the hospitals also, and I spoke to students who were in detail inside the police station and who were later brought to the hospital at Apollo and Holy Family and Al-Shifa Hospital. All of the students who were detained that I spoke to, all of them were not even part of the protest when they were attacked. They were inside the library, they were studying. The police entered inside the library. Now, let me explain to you, because I'm familiar with the area, what actually happened. The police van being set on fire. Now, it's very, as my fellow former student, as the other student from Jamia said, that there are photos which suggest that Delhi police was themselves involved in the arson. Even let's set that aside for a moment. That happened in Mata Mandir Road, which is about 1.5 kilometers away from Jamia Millia Islamia.
Oh, nice.
Stone pelting, who did that, whether it was local, whether it was... Just let me finish, Dr. Mr. Kakkar. I mean, you've made your point. Let me make my point. The stone pelting which they are speaking about even also happened about 1 kilometer away from the university. Now, what justifies the police entering the university library and beating students who are 1.5 kilometers away from the scene of violence? Now, when the police was beating up students, the students I spoke to at the hospital last night after they were released from detention, they told me that the police snatched their phones.
I demand the Jamia administration, because they have extended solidarity with the students, that they should make those CCTV footage public. That will bring the truth out as to how unprovoked this attack was. We have seen videos of female students being attacked by male police officers. These videos have gone viral, and how the police completely unprovoked way were attacking female students have said that they were sexually molested by male police officers inside the library when they were attacked. They were groped and all of that. So it's very clear the images. And it's not just Jamia Islam. Same thing happened in Aligarh Muslim University at late at night. So it's very clear there is a pattern. And an action like this is not possible without orders from the top. Now, it's very important to find out who gave those orders. Delhi Police comes under the Home Minister. The Home Minister steered the Citizenship Amendment Act. Now, they're trying to vitiate the atmosphere after having lost the public debate on Citizenship Amendment Act. They've passed it through brute majority inside the parliament, but they have lost their... So they're trying to vitiate the space. They're trying to plant. I mean, you never know who these outsiders are. You never know whether these outsiders are planting themselves to create the situation. So it's very clear that they don't want the merits of CAB to be debated, and they want to make it a law and order issue. Hmm. Jamia students have not indulged in absolutely any violence. If you go and speak to students...
Umar, isn't it convenient, because we saw the same excuse, same reason being given in JNU, same reason given to us for the Jadavpur University, you know, controversy that erupted, and now Jamia Millia saying, well, outsiders came in and outsiders really took charge and outsiders pelted stones and they set property on fire. Isn't there a pattern here to put the blame on somebody else? Who are these outsiders and how are they being allowed inside?
See, number one, as I said, and I'm familiar with the area, the arson that the Delhi police is speaking about, that arson did not take place near the university. That arson took place 1.5 kilometers away from the university. It's a residential area. Now, who these outsiders are, that's for the police to find out. But what I want to make clear is that, yes, there is a pattern. The pattern is that from Assam to Delhi to Aligarh Muslim University, everywhere the police and the government is using force to quell protesters. It's not just about Jamia Millia Islamia. You see in Assam, 4 people have been killed. You see in Assam, Meghalaya, Tripura, internet is snapped. We heard Aligarh Muslim University, internet is snapped. But you don't like certain... And I'm not even getting into the merits of CAB right now, though we have to speak about that as well. But you don't like certain voices. What do you do with them? You snap out internet. You simply send the police there. Arrest people like Akhil Gogoi, who's a peasant leader in Assam. And what does this government actually think of itself? It thinks of itself as some kind of an authoritarian regime that it is going to go and quell people's voices. Mm. If the BJP government thinks that it's a BJP government, I would want to remind them it's not the BJP government, it's the government of India. And so, if the government of India wants to speak about Sabka Saath and Sabka Vishwas, then they have to listen to genuine grievances of people.
Okay, I agree. When there are protests happening across 15 cities and 16 universities, then there is definitely a large amount of anger which cannot be simply called as a conspiracy by the opposition. Frankly, if the opposition had this kind of a strength, they would have probably gotten some more votes in the general election. So there is something that's definitely being said. The government listens to that, needs to listen to that voice. But let me come back to the visuals that we were just playing. Now, we don't know. We cannot assume facts. I'm just simply going to put this out there for everybody else to see and for the police to investigate what went on. But you can see, at one point yesterday, there were these miscreants on the streets. They were pelting stones. They were roaming around with sticks and destroying buses. There was a traffic jam that had taken place because of the protests. And those stuck in that jam had to bear the brunt because of these miscreants. Now, have these people been arrested? Why were they allowed to become a part of this protest? Who are these people? Are they students? Are they someone else? Are they politically connected? Those are the answers we need now from the police and the government. Mr. Nail Banerjee, but do you agree that the responsibility is also on the peacefully protesting students to ensure that outsiders don't hijack their protests?
Tanvi, the discussion has gone on, and it is ignored the fact that the Vice Chancellor of Jamia in a press conference has accepted that they have come across 750 fake ID cards of the university. These 750 fake identity cards are of those people whom you can classify as outsiders. That is number one. Number two, the Jamia administration has been lax by not informing the local police of having found these cards over the last so many days. Each university, you have named a couple of places where problems have taken place, but everywhere the focus is different. In Jamia, the focus is very different. In AMU, it is almost similar, but in Assam, it is against the outsider, as they claim it.
Yes.
It is not only against the CAB. And what about West Bengal? You have not covered the six. Absolutely, they have almost destroyed 25,000 crores of property.
Yes.
And here we are just talking about a very small, localized incident which has taken place in Delhi. Number one, the Jamia administration is extremely lax. Let me also tell you about the law. As Mr. Kakkad has very correctly pointed out, any demonstration, any agitation by any student is welcome. I have been a student. I have been a student leader. I have also seen this kind of a thing. And the lumpenization of a student movement takes place instantly. Absolutely instantly. If the panelists are aghast at the fact that the police has been chasing, excuse me, let me please complete. I have heard all of you out. Kindly let me complete. If you believe that you can shout me down, please proceed to do so.
Yes, let Mr. Banerjee finish.
Who is this? Who is this shouting? Tanvi? No, Tanvi, who is this shouting?
Umar Khalid has a question for you, but I want you to finish.
Person who's shouting.
Yes.
Today, yes, Umar, let me tell you, today is 16th of December. Today is 16th of December. Today is the day when Indian Army won a victory, the biggest victory in East Pakistan, now Bangladesh. We should have been celebrating that rather than discussing this nonsense. But we are back to this nonsense. And let me tell you that this is not the place that you should interrupt me. Please, let me proceed. Let me please complete. You have your right to reply. You have your right to reply. And the chasing of very correctly, it has been pointed out that people who are indulging in any kind of violence, even if it is inside the campus, the police is entitled under the law to chase them. You see, the police does not enter the campuses just for the fact that peace should be maintained,
yes,
by and large. However, in case a crime is committed, in case a criminal is hiding, and there are 750 criminals, as I've just pointed out, who are probably in and around the university. So for that, if the police has entered the university, it is no big deal. Yes.
No, sir, Mr. Banerjee, it is a big deal.
Disturbing.
It is a big deal with the way, the kind of force that you use, Mr. Banerjee.
No, it is not.
There has to be a process. There has to be a process. If there is rioting happening inside, there has to be a process. You can't rush into the libraries, the classrooms, girls' hostels, and start dragging people out without knowing whether they were even part of this protest or not. Look, Mr. Banerjee, you have to see some of those videos and voices that we've got of children so scared, packing their bags, packing up their suitcases, getting the next rickshaw out, getting the next train and the next bus out back to their homes. It's not their fault. They were not part of this protest. They were simply there studying. Somebody hijacked this protest to the level that these students had to suffer. It's not their fault at all. There has to be some system in place. In fact, Mr. Banerjee, I know I interrupted you and I'm sorry about that. But I just want to bring out a voice of one of the other students. Listening to a student who was detained. He claims he was allegedly beaten by the cops and then released. Take a look.
Mirror now is bringing you the voice of one of the students who were beaten up by the police when they started their crackdown yesterday evening.
मैं खुशकिस्मत था कि मुझको सर पे नहीं मारा गया या हाथ वगैरह अपने पे जो भी पड़ा मुझको यहीं पे मारा गया और मेरे कुछ साथी तो उनको मतलब साहब ने वीडियो वगैरह देखी होगी फोटो वगैरह देखी होगी वहां पर उनका सर भी फटा है हाथ वगैरह भी टूटा हुआ है उन लोग हम लोग साथ गए थे 25 तकरीबन 35 लोग थे सब लोग साथ गए थे तकरीबन आधे घंटे बाद पूरा सीनेरियो चेंज हो गया सब लोग मतलब वहां पर बैठे हुए थे पुलिस वगैरह आ गई ऊपर तक तो हमारे सीनियर वगैरह ने दरवाजा लाइब्रेरी का लॉक कर दिया ताकि अंदर ना आ सके और हमारा जो लाइब्रेरी का दरवाजा है वो शीशे वगैरह शीशा का है तो उन्होंने शीशा को अपनी लाठियों से तोड़ा उसके बाद अंदर उन्होंने 5-6 लोग जिनमें ज़्यादातर लोग सीआरपीएफ के थे और दिल्ली पुलिस के भी एक दो बंदे थे मेरे ख्याल से उन्होंने अंदर हलते ही सबको एक तरह से मारा कोई किसी को ही नहीं कोई हाथ उठाए हुए सबको मतलब एक तरफ से कोई लड़की है चाहे लड़का हो सब पे अटैक करना शुरू कर दिया अपने कुछ पूरी अफरा तफरी मच गई लाइब्रेरी आप बहुत कंजेस्टेड आप गए होंगे अगर तो देखा होगा तो वहाँ पर भागने की जगह नहीं थी कोई टेबल के नीचे था कोई चेयर के नीचे जा रहा था लेकिन वो लोग जिसको जहाँ पाए मारने लगे अब कुछ लोग उसमें भागे भी जो गेट के करीब थे हम लोग पीछे वगैरह थे हम लोग को मतलब जब मारा गया तो हम लोग गिर गए ज़मीन पर जिसकी वजह से मतलब जैसे पैर में ज़्यादा तेज मारा था तो हम लोग को जैसे घसी टाइप आ गई तो हम लोग ज़मीन में गिर गए तो वहाँ से हम लोग को डिटेन किया गया
एंड एंटरिंग द लाइब्रेरी मिस्टर बैनर्जी इज दैट जस्टिफाइड
I was chased as a student leader. I was chased into my college and they kept chasing me till I somehow managed to escape. You see, the point is that if you have committed something, if they have chased a person into a library or wherever, there it must have been. Just because this gentleman is saying that he was studying in the library and not doing anything, he just got caught up. Maybe out of those 750 people whom the vice chancellor of the Jamia says, are illegal students or illegal people who've entered Jamia, one of them must have been in the library.
I wanted to make a point, go ahead please, before I go across to our political representatives. Akshay Marathe, spokesperson of the Aam Aadmi Party, also joining us this evening, and Aman Sinha, our national spokesperson for the BJP. Good evening to you. Umar, first up, just make your point, please, go ahead.
I mean, first of all, he's spoken about, he's got a figure of 750 people. Now, I want to ask that, I am an alumni of JNU. If tomorrow something is happening in JNU and I happen to visit JNU at that point of time, do I become an illegal person? I don't know where that figure has come from. The point is that for him, I mean, he's saying that just because someone is saying so and someone might have been caught. I was there at the hospital yesterday and they told me that some of the students who were detained, were not just detained from the library, some of the students were detained by the police from the Holy Family Hospital when they were in the emergency ward being treated. So when people are speaking about the lumpenization of students, they should also look back at the lumpenization of Delhi police and the videos amply show the way the students were by the students. As I'm saying that this violence, that this is being made a big deal out of, because if the students, if there was violence against the police, which was 2%, 98% of the violence was by the police. And that even 2% happened 1.5 hours away from the university. So that has no connection with what the police was doing inside the library. The other point I want to make, there is being made, this thing being made, and Tanvi, I disagree with you, about anything being hijacked. The Citizenship Amendment Act affects every citizen of this country, and every citizen of this country, whether they are students or non-students, whether in Jamia Millia Islamia or in Assam or in Indagate or in Jantar Mantar or in a few days in Delhi, in other parts of Delhi, they are protesting, they have a right to protest. The Citizenship Amendment Act, let me say, this is unconstitutional because it links religion with citizenship. One last point I want to make, Mr. Kakkar spoke about how it does not affect Indians. Maybe he has not heard the statement by the Home Minister when he says that lending, and anyone who does not have documents will be rendered stateless. Almost they will be rehabilitated under the CAB. Hmm. Now, in our country, where the professor cannot produce his college degree, do you expect 130 crore Indians to have documents dating back to 30, 40 years? There is anxiety, there is panic among citizens of this country, irrespective of their religious background, across the country, from West Bengal to Assam to Tripura to Meghalaya to Delhi to Maharashtra to Jharkhand to Tamil Nadu. And you are saying that this is being instigated and hijacked by some people? It's the real fear of people. And it's the government, it's calling itself the representative of everyone, rather than starting a dialogue, rather than responding to students, rather than responding to citizens, sports, snaps the internet, beats students to pulp. I mean, you're saying it's no big deal. Of course, it's no big deal for you because none of your friends.
Umar, there are two different points. Umar, there are two different points. The merits or the demerits of a protest over Citizenship Amendment Act. Yes, that's a different debate. When I say it's if the protest right now, peaceful protest of the students is being hijacked by those politically motivated or otherwise, I am talking about the fact that there have been MLAs, political party MLAs, who've been delivering speeches in that area. I am talking about the fact that in many of these places, there were Congress supporters, Congress political representatives who were part of these protests. And I'm not just talking about Delhi. Reporters across the cities have brought us this information where protesters themselves have admitted. I'm talking about the opposition sitting on this and making statements. So there is an attempt to hijack that doesn't take away from the genuine anger that students may have, students do have, and it's their right to protest and to express that. Aman Sinha, good evening to you. How can this be a politically motivated nationwide protest when there are thousands of them across 16 different universities? Do you really believe the opposition is capable of organizing this?
No, Tanvi, first of all, violent protests are absolutely unfortunate and distressing. Violence is not going to lead to anything, and therefore I appeal to everybody through your channel to maintain peace and harmony. This is what Prime Minister Narendra Modi ji has also done. This is what Chief Justice of India, Justice Bobde, also said when this matter was mentioned in Supreme Court today. And he said that whoever it may be, whether students or anybody else, nobody has got right to take law into in his own hands. And look at what has happened, Tanvi. Large number of buses, vehicles, trains in other places, they have been burnt, they have been damaged. Public property has been damaged, even in Delhi. Large number of other vehicles have been damaged. People, common passers-by were inconvenienced, they were attacked. And therefore, this has happened. Everything will be inquired and investigated upon. There are certain allegations and counter-allegations, but nobody can run away from the fact that large number of public buses, public property was damaged, public buses were burned. And therefore, this has happened. Now, clearly, police was trying to contain the situation. And there are certain allegations that police entered the campus. That will also be inquired and looked into. But let me say that it is deeply distressing and unfortunate that some political parties are misusing our campuses and trying to mislead the students and youngsters. Because clearly, Tanvi, as far as Citizenship Amendment Act is concerned, it does not affect rights of any citizens or anybody who is residing in India. And therefore, I do not know why would anybody who's here will start protesting.
No, but Aman Sinha, that's exactly my point.
Clearly, it only provides a mechanism
for
giving refuge to those people who have been suffering religious persecution for a large number of years.
Okay, but do you really believe 16 universities, Aman Sinha, 16 universities?
Congress party had a protest rally, Mamata Banerjee had a protest rally.
I don't want to talk about Mamata Banerjee's protest rally or Priyanka Gandhi's, frankly. Yes, but their politics is not my interest. My interest is what's going on in the college campuses and universities. 16 universities saw protest today, Aman Sinha, including three of the premier IIT institutions, including Varanasi, Puducherry, Mumbai, Bengaluru, Chennai, Lucknow, Hyderabad, Bhopal, Patna, Delhi, all of these cities. Are you seriously suggesting that you believe all of this is because of your rival political parties, that none of these youngsters have a mind of their own, a voice of their own?
No, first of all, Tanvi, I strongly contest if there are any one or two discordant notes or any exceptions. You cannot pass a sweeping blanket judgment and say that this is the voice of that university. Now, as far as, and as I also mentioned to you, because university, they are all scholarly, well-educated people. They have all, I presume, read the Citizenship Amendment Act, and they all know that nobody's rights, regardless of their religion, caste, creed, or whatever background that they come from, their rights are not being affected. It only provides a mechanism for giving refuge to those who are religiously persecuted in neighboring theocratic states. So therefore, why should anybody be having any problems with that? I do not understand. And in university, I also say that they are all scholarly, educated people. They also know that this act in no way or manner affects their right. There are a handful of people, these are some political parties, some groups, usual suspects, Tanvi, who time and again have been instigating, misleading students, universities. And if there are one or two discordant voices, if there are certain exceptions at
because you're a lawyer.
You cannot pass a sweeping blanket judgment that this is the voice of the university.
So let's attempt this for the
next... Just 10 seconds more, Tanvi. 10 seconds more. Now, Tanvi, you have seen that as far as leftists are concerned, a large number of other political parties, they have lost immense ground.
Correct.
And
so why are you giving them undue credit by saying that it's their fault?
Are concerned.
Okay.
And that
okay.
is also reflected
Aman Sinha, let's attempt
in
this.
Electoral processes.
Please now, listen to me. Since you are also a qualified lawyer and a respected lawyer.
Bastions, they are trying to cobble up something or other and put up a discordant note.
Okay.
That cannot be in any way termed as... No, that cannot be termed in any way as the opinion of the university.
Okay, let's attempt this. And Akshay Marathe, I will request you to be patient for 5 more minutes because I genuinely want to do this. Now, I have a student who is a fourth-year law student from Jamia University, Safiyat Naseem. Aman Sinha, let's attempt this. Listen to what Safiyat has to say. She is also a law student. Tomorrow, she will be a respected lawyer like you. Let's understand why she thinks... This bill is a problem and that she has a right to protest. Safiyat.
Sir, very respectfully, I really wanted to ask this. If this bill is not against Muslims and this will not create hindrance, why is the government, first of all, afraid to listen to us? They are suppressing our voices down. Secondly, why there is no mention of Muslims in the list? Also, according to Article 14 of the Indian Constitution, it says that there should be provision of equality before law and equal protection of law for every person in India, not just citizens, but every person. And you cannot make any law on the basis of the religions. CAB and NCR are, together.
Okay.
Yes, Tanvi, may I respond?
Yes, please, Aman Sinha. Please explain to this young student,
Safiyat. One of my friends.
Yes, Safiyat, you say the government doesn't listen to you. You are a representative of the ruling party.
My best
Let him explain to you why they don't see this this law is a problem.
Can you just allow me to respond? I got the question.
Yes, Aman Sinha.
So first of all, my best wishes to the law student. And I'm sure she has... read the Citizenship Amendment Act. First of all and foremost, it only provides a mechanism for giving refuge to those who are religiously persecuted in neighboring theocratic states. It does not affect rights of any citizens, which is evident from a plain reading of the Act, which I'm sure the student has done. Now, it in no way is discriminatory. Let me say that Section 5 of the Citizenship Act and Section 6 of the Citizenship Act provide citizenship by naturalization or registration. And there is no change which is sought to be made either in Section 5 or Section 6. Any Muslim brother, any Muslim person from neighboring countries, they have earlier also applied and got citizenship, about 5,000-6,000 of them. And today also they can apply and they are being considered for citizenship. There is no discrimination at all. And as far as citizenship is concerned, the Citizenship Amendment Act per se does not make any provision for providing straight away citizenship to anybody. It only makes a mechanism for those who are facing religious persecution and where the numbers, the enormity of problem is such, Tanvi, and all of you know that these people who are 20-25% in neighboring theocratic countries, their numbers have come down to minuscule 1-2%. And large number of minorities here, in fact, all of them, Tanvi, in India, if you consider 1947 as a timeline, their numbers have grown substantially.
Okay.
And therefore, this is the enormity of problem. It needed to be addressed. But such misgivings, and I'm sure that law students will see the law, will study the law, will analyze the law, and will speak in an objective manner and not get misguided and misled by those who are legally illiterate and who only have political motives.
Quick response, Mr. Sinha, from the student. Yes, Safiyat.
Sir, Sir, what if someone is not able to prove their citizenship according to this? Okay, if they are not able to prove it, because everyone does not have their all documents and all, people are being born on the footpaths. So this act provides citizenship and in 6 years to Hindus, Muslims, non-Muslims, to every non-Muslim, but not Muslims, will be considered as second-class citizens. One of my friend who's studying in Jamia, he's a Assamese student.
No,
he's from Assam. And he has got his, he doesn't have his name on NCR, on his list. His name is on detention list.
Okay, so what often also happens is that
he's studying in Jamia for 3 years.
NRC and citizen amendmentship are two different things. Though yes, they are linked, and there is a larger fear. Aman Sinha,
I have gathered her question.
Yes,
yes. Allow me to respond.
Yes, okay, go ahead, please, and then I go to Akshay Marathe.
No, no, may I respond? She's put in specific questions. Please allow me to respond. Yes, Tanvi, first of all, as I mentioned to you, that Section 5 and Section 6 of the Citizenship Act provide for acquiring of citizenship by naturalization and registration. No amendment is sought to be made. And previously also, even during tenure of this government from 2014 onwards, large number of Muslims have applied from neighboring countries. They have been given citizenship and they can continue to do so. And they will continue to do so and they will be considered and citizenship will be given to them also. But the fact is that there is a complete misreading of the act and these students are being misled because there is no the Citizenship Amendment Act does not mention anything about NRC. I do not know why people are connecting it, because Citizenship Amendment Act, the amendment is limited to the respect that those who are facing religious persecution will be given some protection and refuge here. That is all. Even in terms of their getting citizenship,
okay,
it does not provide them any additional qualification per se. And now, secondly, even as far as NRC is concerned, even if somebody's name is missing in NRC, nobody becomes a foreigner straight away. There is a foreigner's tribunal which has been constituted for that purpose. And as long as that foreigner's tribunal does not adjudicate that that particular person is not from India or is a foreigner, nobody is going to be ousted.
Okay, and let me just say this, Mr. Sinha, I need to go across to Akshay Marathe as well.
Misgivings, and therefore,
so we can have more of these conversations where the BJP needs to get its messaging right. If you believe there is no threat to the secular fabric of this country, there is no threat to the Muslims in this country, because obviously tonight there are students across 16 universities who are literally voicing what many others are also feeling. It's the responsibility of the government. I want to go across to Akshay Marathe now and ask him this question. Why, Akshay, are political parties trying to hijack what is essentially a students' movement right now, a students' protest? What job did Amanatullah Khan have going about delivering speeches in that area yesterday?
Tanvi, at the outset, I must make this clear that Aam Aadmi Party, right from the beginning, from the first time that the news came in that some buses have been burnt, Mr. Arvind Kejriwal tweeted immediately that all violence is condemnable. He called the Lieutenant Governor and he requested the LG to get the situation under control. We are against violence from the day one itself. We are not a party that either indulges in violence or condones violence. Number one. Number two, violence from all sides is condemnable. Just as violence that was done on the buses of Delhi is condemnable, the brutal attack of the Delhi police on students, innocent students of Jamia, inside libraries, inside girls' hostels, inside bathrooms, is absolutely despicable. And that is why students from across the country are rising up in protest against this kind of a dictatorial action by the BJP. This is point number two. Point number three is very clear. I think it's important for people to understand the context of what is going on right now. We are in one of the most dangerous difficult economic crises that India has seen in a long time. We have very high levels of unemployment. And at this point in time, the priority of the central government is not to provide jobs for Indians. Mm. It's not to provide relief, economic relief to Indians. It is opening up arms. Say 3 crore Hindus from all neighboring countries are welcome. Come, we'll give you jobs, we'll give you housing, we'll give you Tanvi, electricity, we'll give respond? You water. Yeah, what about the people who are living in this country? No, are you? No. You're not able to take care of the people who are already living in this country, okay. And now you want to light a fire, manufacture a disaster, yes, in the name of this,
gentleman,
and you
want
to divide this country. That is the dirty politics that the BJP
the Deputy
is unleashing
Chief Minister of
on
government
this country.
Of NCT of
this
Delhi
is in the last,
yesterday
in the last
was propagating, spreading fake news.
In the last 30 years,
trying to investigate
people's lives. Please, please, this is not a political debate. 1 minute, please, gentlemen. 1 minute. This is not a political debate at all over the merits of citizenship. Amendment Act.
This is
not the subject matter. This is not a political debate on merits of citizenship amendment. We'll do it another day. We've done enough of those debates. Akshay, you're not responding to my question. What was Amanatullah Khan doing in that area, delivering speeches, inciting people? I'm asking you this question straight up. I don't care about what Arvind Kejriwal messaged and tweeted after the violence had taken place. Who led to the violence is my question.
Tanvi, I want to ask you a simple question. Amanatullah is the MLA of that area where these protests were taking place. Amanatullah was addressing a peaceful protest outside the university, not inciting violence. There is not a shred of evidence where you can see Amanatullah calling for violence of any kind. I want to challenge the BJP to show at least one video in which Amanatullah is saying, let's go burn buses. Amanatullah Khan is an MLA of that area. He has a right to
what Amanatullah Khan was saying.
I want to challenge the
was completely communal, was completely instigating a mob to indulge into communal violence.
Aman Sinha, respond please.
Yes, yes,
this
not one piece, but several pieces. He was instigating in name of religion. And I say it with all authority and conviction. I do not even wish to repeat the kind of inexplicable words that Amanatullah Khan was using.
Yes, one at a time, please. We had a very, very calm, peaceful debate.
Was busy instigating crowd
on the channel. I just want to listen to what Aman Sinha has to say. Akshay Malhotra, please listen to what the BJP is responding.
That is the only reason that
don't force me to put the audio down of our panelists, please. Aman Sinha, respond to what Akshay Malhotra is saying.
Thank you very much, Tanvi, because large number of baseless allegations were made by this gentleman. Now, first of all, Mr. Amanatullah Khan was instigating in name of religion. There is a plethora of evidence. We have all seen those videos. And it is not even something which I can repeat. I do not wish to, you know, add fuel to the fire. And therefore, I'm not repeating it. But let me say, I say with all conviction and all authority that whatever he was saying was blatantly communal. He was trying to instigate the crowd and attack another group of people in name of religion, which is absolutely unbecoming of an elected representative of that area. What was he doing? And that was the crowd or mob perhaps, or those miscreants which entered along and which entered into the group of students and started indulging in this violence. And Mr. Marathe gave such a long lecture. He's from Aam Aadmi Party. And his deputy chief minister, when this violence was going on, Tanvi, on streets of Delhi, he was busy adding more fuel to the fire by saying that police,
yes,
are responsible for burning of these buses. And when they were at that time dousing the fire, there are not one but large number of buses which caught fire in different areas in that particular vicinity. And he put out a picture that police is burning buses. This is the kind of irresponsible leadership which Aam Aadmi Party provides. And therefore, people will see through all this. But let me say that when such situation is prevailing, it is absolutely abhorring and irresponsible for constitutional functionaries like Deputy Chief Minister of the State to conduct and behave themselves in such an irresponsible manner.
Okay. Akshay Marathe, you can respond now so that we can hear both sides of the story.
Allow me to respond. Tanvi, the fact of the matter is there are 2 months left to the Delhi election, and the BJP has tried very hard in the last few months, but they have found nothing to corner Arvind Kejriwal and the Aam Aadmi Party. In the name of these protests, the BJP is trying to manufacture and whip up some kind of controversy against the Aam Aadmi Party, but it's not going to be useful because people understand that whenever there are elections, it's not just about Delhi. Look at the history of the Bharatiya Janata Party in the last 30 years. Right before an election, they will manufacture some kind of dissent, some kind of violence, just to make people insecure, to incite people's primal instincts, make them fearful. This is standard signature BJP style of politics. This is exactly what they are doing in Delhi, but people of Delhi are peace-loving people. We want harmony. We don't want this kind of violence. Aam Aadmi Party is the first party to reject violence of any kind. But the BJP's track record on violence is for everybody to see. All your viewers today
did Manish Sisodia verify the information and the pictures that he tweeted out?
10 seconds,
were
Tanvi.
They verified and put out, or did you simply just get something off the internet and put it out saying, look what's happening? Akshay Marathe, did Manish Sisodia verify what he was sharing?
Tanvi, the video shared by Manish Sisodia is not his own video. He simply retweeted a Nav Bharat Times Twitter video, not shared by any protester or the police.
Well, the Deputy Chief Minister
You can go and check right now. Sure. Log on to your Twitter.
Sure.
He shared a video tweeted by Nav Bharat Times.
Sure.
It was not a video that he has manufactured. If this video is incorrect, let the Delhi police investigate. Who has lit the fire? Let them punish the real culprits.
Okay.
Who is against a real investigation? All that we are saying is that the police has no right to chase people inside educational institutions and destroy the campuses of our colleges and make children live in fear of the police.
Okay, I am going to thank few of our panelists right now as we come to an end of a conversation about the political hijacking of these protests. Our politicians fueling this unrest was one part of it. But I want to ask Umar Khalid and Safiyat to stay on with me. I have two more questions for them about what the youngsters are thinking tonight. Young India across 16 cities and universities is protesting. Why? That conversation will continue. Stay with me here on Urban Debate.